What's up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. So today we're taking a look at your dedicated VRAM or your UMA buffer frame size in our BIOS. This change can help gaming performance, game crashes, and Windows performance as well on the Steam Deck. Those of us who have been using APU laptops for years know about changing this in the BIOS already, so a lot of you may be familiar with this. Works well on the Deck, and we're going to use Epic as our example today, but it's for all third-party launchers or non-Steam launchers like Epic, Origin, Battlenet, Ubisoft, whatever the case may be, it can help with. With SteamOS games, Steam games though, not so much as it does a good job on its own dynamically dealing with the RAM. Now as you can see here on the left we have 1 gig and on the right it's the 4 gig for our VRAM, and while frame rates are very similar and while standing still the frame times are fine, it's when you get into gameplay and things changing more rapidly that dynamic shift causes more frame time issues, stutters and skips in this game and in others. It's not going to be the case all the time, but you can see it here. It's quite a little difference for our frame time and our experience overall with the increased VRAM. Now I'm just using Kingdom Bridge of Spirits here as an example, but it's a pretty decent one for showing you that. Now as far as games not launching, I have a couple of here. Lawn Mowing Simulator is a game. I'll speed this up here, but when I would try to launch in, it would give me trouble with the 1 gigabyte here. Now, it would just wind up freezing up at this point. I did manage to get into the game once or twice, but it wound up crashing before I got into the gameplay. So this was prior to doing the change. Same thing over in DRL Sim, a free game over on Epic. I will only get so far, and then it'll freeze up and have like a black screen. Now, I did manage to actually get into a game once with the 1 gigabyte and get it working. Then it crashed and just didn't want to work again until I changed the VRAM. So just a couple of examples, and you can see here, Lawn Mowing Simulator on 4 gigs will load up just fine for me, and it'll play and not give me any problem. And the same thing over on DRL gets me to the menu now, and I can get into a match or whatever and play the game with the 4 gigabytes. It definitely made a big difference for me with these couple of titles, but these are just examples. Now over in Windows, you can see I already have the dedicated 4 gigs here, so it's being picked up by Task Manager here. You can see our system memory is now down to 11.8 gigabytes because we have dedicated 4 to the VRAM. If we still had the default 1, this would be like 14.8 to 15. So let's go ahead and get into Kena again here on Windows, and while there might not be as big of a difference, you can still see the difference in frame time spikes and stutters here and there, and you can see how the system's dealing with how it shows you the RAM. Same amount being used, but the way it's dedicated just kind of makes a difference on how the games read that and how the system performs. But with that stuff out of the way, showing you some examples, how do we make this change in our BIOS? Let's go ahead and get into that for our Steam Deck and change that UMA frame buffer size. So the first thing we want to do is make sure that your Steam Deck is completely shut down, because you're going to need to be able to boot into your settings menu. So we'll shut this down. Once it's shut down, you're going to hold the up volume and then you're going to press power, and you should hear the deck come on. Don't let go of the up volume until you see your menu come up. Once your menu comes up, you can let go, and now we can go to our setup utility, and you can use your D-pad or your trackpad to move around, and your triggers to click, or your AB. So we're going to go over here to advanced in the BIOS, and then we're going to go down to our UMA frame buffer size. Mine's on 4G right now for 4 gigabytes, but it comes standard at 1G. You can easily change this at any time, but because we have 16 gigabytes of RAM, I'm okay with going 4 gigs, same on a laptop. But if you had 8 gigs, you would have to stick with about 2 at most, because you would really hamper your system's performance for available system RAM. But 4G on the deck's going to work and solve some of our issues with what we're having with some of these games. So once you're done with that, you want to save and exit, or hit your menu button up here. Either way, click yes. We want to save and exit, and now we have our new frame buffer size. Now, as always, guys, be careful when you're playing around in a system BIOS. Make sure you know what you're doing. Don't change anything you don't intend to, and just pay attention. I'm not responsible for anybody clicking on things they shouldn't be in their BIOS, but with messing around with the UMA buffer frame size or your dedicated VRAM, you should be just fine. Anyways, guys, your mileage may vary. You may not have the same experience on the same games, but doing this change can certainly help when it comes to those other launchers or Windows performance on the deck. It can help you get some better frame times. It could help you run games that are otherwise crashing and giving you problems. So I recommend giving it a shot if you're willing to go in and make that change, and if you think you're having some problems that might be fixed with that. Anyways, guys, thanks a lot for coming to check out the video. As always, I hope it helped out. If you haven't already, subscribe, thumbs up, ring the bell, leave me your comments, and I'll see you guys in the next one.